Today in this session, we are going to discuss about career opportunity for commerce students. And in this session, I will be talking about four major headings: entrepreneurship, academic courses, competitive exams, and job opportunities for BCom students. Before choosing your career, a student should think about one most important thing, that is, they should know about themselves. Knowing about themselves means they should know about their psychological profile, understanding the self. Self-analysis is more important while choosing a career, because career is more important because it's going to continue for next 40 to 30 years. So you should be more careful while selecting a career. As for a commerce student, we have many avenues are open. Your friends, teachers, relatives, parents, neighbors would give many suggestions to you, but you are the final person to select your career. Before selecting your career, you should answer one question: what makes me happy? Here, you should note there is a difference between the two words, pleasure and happiness. Pleasure is something which is sensed by our organs. For example, eating a tasty food and playing with your friends, chatting with your friends, going out with your family members, which gives you pleasure. But happiness is totally different, because when you're enjoying doing some work, that gives you happiness. For example, writing a poem, or painting a portrait, or solving a problem in which you are more interested, that gives you happiness. So students should be careful while selecting a career which gives you happiness. Some students are comfortable with numbers, comfortable with some papers. Then they can select accountant as a profession or as a career. Some students are comfortable with dealing with people and dealing with human resources management. Then they can select human resources management as their career. But be careful while selecting a career. You should be more careful, because if you select the right one, you will be in enjoyment for the next 40 to 50 years. When you make a wrong decision, it will make you hell for the next 30 to 40 years. Okay, and improve your English language. I won't say English is a knowledge. English is a language. But in this modern society, modern world, we need English for communication. Whatever may be your field, what you may be in career, which you may be in whichever field you may be, English plays an important role. 84% of communication are in English only. And be comfortable with numbers, ma. Okay, next. My first heading is entrepreneur. After completion of your BCom degree, your girls are having more interest in creativity. An entrepreneur is a important person in the society. Actually, the word entrepreneur is totally different from businessman. A businessman is a person who is doing business. Some may do their family business, some may do business with their friends, etc. But entrepreneur is totally different. An entrepreneur is a person who creates or invent something new in the business field, or who develop a new idea in the existing field. So to become an entrepreneur, you need some special qualities also. So first, we need attitude. That is, you should have a positive thinking attitude. Whatever the situation may be, the situation may be good. Sometimes it may not be good, but you should have a positive thinking. You should feel, I'm capable of doing anything. I can solve this problem. I can achieve more. So attitude is more important for an entrepreneur. Second one, the entrepreneur should be a creative person. In this modern society, creativity plays an important role. We have one wordings, change never change. In Tamil, we can say, matram undre maradad. So the society changes. So you have to create new idea and execute it. So an entrepreneur should be a creative person. And third one, you should have a good relationship with others. As an entrepreneur, you are a owner of the organization. You should have a good relationship with your employees, because employees are just like your family members of the enterprise. And you should have a good relationship with your debtors, creditors, and some other persons. Okay. And last one is, you should have the quality which is more important. That is organizing. So organizing all the works in the enterprise is the most important work of an entrepreneur. So being an entrepreneur, you can achieve more. Okay. As an entrepreneur, you can enjoy the fruit of your hard work and smart work also. All the courses motivate the students to become an employee, to get a job in any organization. When you join as a clerk in an organization and you work hard and you have done some smart work for the organization, and finally, one day, you will retire as an employee from the organization. You can't find your best place to your family members. That is for your daughter or your son or your spouse, anyone. But when you start your own organization and you work hard and do more things for your enterprise and you develop it, finally, you can give your position, that is chairperson position, to your daughter or son. This is a best example of entrepreneurship. Okay, so being a young girl, you have more ideas. So you can start an own enterprise. I have listed some of the quotations given by famous personality for entrepreneurship. First one, the best way to predict the future is to create it. I already told you, in future, we have a change. We need a change. So when you are a creative person, when you can invent something in this market field, you are a needy person. Okay. So second one of the huge mistakes people make is that they try to focus an interest on themselves. You don't choose your passion. Your passion chooses you. Jeff Bezos. Actually, while choosing your career, you should know, I already told you, while choosing your career, you should know in which field you have interest, which gives you enjoyment. Based on that only, you have to choose your career. And next, entrepreneurs living a few years of your life, like most people, owned. So you can spend the rest of your life like most people can't. So as an entrepreneur, you have more creativity and enjoy your life and enjoying your enterprise's activity. Finally, you will achieve more. And last quotation is, success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what are you doing, you will be successful. I already mentioned in my wordings that while selecting your career, you should find the answer for one question. What makes me happy? Which gives me happiness? Because while doing your work, you should enjoy. There should be an interest on that particular job. It gives you full happiness. For example, everybody used to say, my mom's foods are very nice. I used to love it because she is doing it with own interest. She is doing it for a son or daughter. So she put everything which is good for them, isn't it? And he cared for the food. So it's very tasty. The same manner, you should also enjoy your career. While selecting your career, you should be very careful. Okay, entrepreneur is one of the platforms which gives you happiness. If you are really a creative person, if really you are a positive thinking person, entrepreneurship gives happiness to your whole career, and you can provide job opportunities to others. If you start an enterprise, minimum you can provide job opportunity for 10 people. Isn't it? And next, I have listed some of the famous entrepreneurs at national, international, and at Tamil Nadu level. First person is Jeff Bezos. Jeff Bezos is a famous personality. He is a founder of Amazon. Amazon, we know, who deliver goods and goods to the doorsteps of the customer. Actually, he started his institute in early 90s. Within this 30 years, he achieved more. His enterprise have branches throughout the world. And next person is Bill Gates. He is a founder of Microsoft. Mark Zuckerberg. He is a founder of Facebook. I think everybody is having an account with Facebook. Facebook gives an idea. It creates creativity. It helps to know about yourself like that. And the next person is Rupert Murdoch. He is the founder of Star Groups. And next, Dhirubhai Ambani. I think he is a national personality. He is a famous entrepreneur. He is a person who introduced mobile phones at less cost, minimum cost. I think it's they have introduced mobile phones in 2004 for ₹1,500. They offer two mobile phones. It's a Reliance phones. It's just like it's a small phone, but it is an idea. Before that, we have to spend more amount for purchase of mobile phones. So he used creativity in the field of mobile phones. And here is a person, C.K. Ranganathan. He is a founder of Kevin Care. He is a person from Tamil Nadu. And he is also from a normal family only. He is a person who introduced shampoos in sachet. Before that, we have to purchase shampoos in bottles. For that, we have to spend more amount, but he is a person who introduced shampoos in sachets. With this, a person can purchase a sachet for ₹50 or 1 rupee, isn't it? It's a kind of creativity. And next one is Kalanidhi Maran. He is a founder of Sun Groups. I think in all languages, we have Santi. They have started their career in early 90s only. Okay. Finally, we have one personality. You can search in Google also. You can search as an idli man. His original name is Iniyavan, but is known or famous by the name idli man. He is from poor family and he is not that much educated. But he started his career as a seller of idli batter. In Tamil, we used to say idli mavu. He is a person who is selling idli mavu. But slowly, he introduced creativity in the field of idli batters. He started selling idlis to the hotels, restaurants, malls, and Kalyana Mandapam. We all know idli is a South Indian food which we had for our breakfast, isn't it? So his creativity has been accepted. You know, he supplies only idli. He won't supply side dishes, that is sambar, chutney, and molaka pudi and all. He won't supply. He supplies only idlis. You know something? He introduced creativity in this field also. Now, he is supplying 2,500 varieties of idli throughout Tamil Nadu. He is a person with minimum education qualification. So, entrepreneurship plays an important role. It gives an opportunity. Because being an entrepreneur, you are your own, being your own boss. You are not an employee. You enjoy the fruit of your hard work, ideas, creativity, and everything. I already told you, as a young girl, you have more ideas. And government also conducting many EDP programs, that is entrepreneur development programs, free programs also conducted by government, and all banks allot loans to the women entrepreneur. So after completing your BCom degree, you can start your career as an entrepreneur, because you and your family members enjoy the fruit of your hard work, and you can provide job opportunity for others, and you will surely get a best place in the society. One of my student who started foodie industry, he started supplying breakfast, lunch, and dinner to IT industries. Slowly he developed herself. And I come across one more girl who has utilized this pandemic situation. She has introduced online tuitions on spoken English courses for kids. Slowly, she developed within this 3 to 4 months. Okay. In our area, 4 young boys join together and they plan this pandemic situation. They used to deliver vegetables and provisions to the needy people and charge service charges from them. So, to become an entrepreneur, you need a creativity. Just go through the situations and use it for yourself and be your own boss. Okay, next topic is academic courses and exams. After completion of your BCom, you can join MBA, MCom, CA, CS, ICWA. I'll start my lecture with MBA. MBA means Master in Business Administration, and we have many specialization in MBA. MBA specialization offers promotes career development, induce career changes, enhance knowledge, skill, and abilities development, leads to personal development. And these are the area we have specialization in MBA. MBA in finance, marketing, human resources, international business, operation management, rural management, agribusiness management, and many of the engineering colleges and arts and science colleges offer MBA degree. But when you crack MBA degree in famous top universities or top institutes, you will get a best place, because in future, we are in need of MBA graduates. When you complete your MBA degree, You can be placed in a multinational company with a good package of salary. Okay, so next we will see the specializations. Before that, to complete your MBA in famous institute like Indian Institute of Management, you have to crack one common exam, that is CAT exam, Common Admission Test. This test is an all India test conducted by Indian Institute of Management. So to get a chance to study in famous institute, you have to crack this exam, CAT exam. And the bachelor, that is UG, if you have for that, to crack the MBA exams, entrance exam, you must score at least 50% in your bachelor degree, and you will get the, you can search and find out the details in website also. And for CAT exam, actually, it is a 3 hours exam. Here they used to test your quantitative ability, verbal ability, reading comprehensions, data interpretation, and logical reasoning. In quantitative ability, they used to check your arithmetic accuracy. You have to solve the problem within a minimum period because you have only 3 hours and you have 34 questions. 34 questions will be given to you. So you need regular practice. Many institute provides training for this CAT exams. Otherwise, you can download the material from the website and practice at home. It will help you. But practice alone help you to score marks. Next, in verbal ability and reading comprehension, they used to check your English knowledge, grammatical part like that. And data interpretation, logical reasoning, we have a table and the question will be asked based on the table. And logical reasoning questions is also given. So you have to practice for this CAT exam. And these are the famous institute where you can complete or join your MBA. Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, Ahmedabad, Calcutta, Delhi, Madras, Lucknow, Kozhikode, like this. So you can have a, after cracking your CAT exam, you can join in any one of these institutes and get a best placement in any multinational company. Once again. Okay. Next, if you want to select or join MBA in finance, and these are your career opportunities, career options, expert in financial management related areas, banking sectors, insurance industries, mutual funds industries, stock exchange, financial consulting, manager of the highly responsible departments and functions in the organization pertaining, assistant manager, like that. Okay. When you sell, and these are the subjects in MBA in finance. Financial management, managerial economics, accounting for managers, like that. These are the subjects. And next, when you select MBA in marketing, we all know, aware of that, marketing is a backbone of an organization. When you select marketing in MBA, your career options will be marketing manager, head of digital marketing, product manager, media planner, sales manager, brand manager, corporate sales manager, market research analyst. When you select MBA in HR as your career options will be team player, team leader, assistant HR manager, regional HR manager, senior HR manager, director HR, chief HR officer. And when you choose MBA in international business, your career options will be international foreign policy advisor, international trading and customs manager, business development director, multinational manager, financial collector, international marketing director. When you select MBA in operation management, your career options will be operations executive, assistant manager, deputy manager, area operation manager, like that. When you select MBA in rural management, your career options will be jobs with the Government of India's Rural Development Project, association with non-government organization, research institutes conducting extensive research on rural areas, a chance to join hands with United National and its subordinates or social research agencies. And when you choose MBA in Agri Business Management, career options can be agri industries, food industries, farm engineering, livestock industries, like that. And if you are really interested in teaching after completion of your BCom, you can select MCom. After completion of your MCom, you can join PhD part-time or full-time. While doing PhD, you can clear state level and national level eligibility tests conducted in national and state level. Actually, MCom is a 2 years course. And next is, we are going to discuss about company secretaryship. After completion of company secretaryship course, you can be placed in key managerial person in an organization. Key managerial person means he is the top authority of an organization. While doing company secretaryship, you may have a knowledge, you may increase your knowledge, you are trained in particular fields. Example, finance, accounting, legal, administrative, personal areas, etc. Actually, to clear this, we have to complete three steps. First, you have to attend one entrance exam. The entrance is after 2020, they have changed the method of CS exams. First, you have to crack this CSEET test, that is Company Secretaryship Executive Entrance Test. You are eligible to attend this test after completion of your 12th standard. And second stage is executive exams. And to join the executive exam directly, you have one more option. That is, if you cleared foundation in CS or CA or ICWA, you can directly join an executive exams. And third stage is professional exams. In professional exams, we have three modules and some papers is also discussed. And your career options are secretary in HR, marketing, administration, CEO office, and in finance. Chartered accountant. Chartered accountant is a dream of all the commerce students. When a student select commerce as a subject in 11th standard, they want to join CA course and complete CA course. They want to become a chartered accountant. But you need training, because here also we have three stages. But first one is a foundation. Second one is intermediate, and third one is final exam. And After completion of your chartered accountant, you can be an auditor of any company. I won't say career opportunities for chartered accountant, because chartered accountant, job of chartered accountant is very different, responsible job. He is a person who is responsible for the financial position of the organization. So here I have list out the responsibilities of chartered accountant. So he have to manage financial system and budget, and he have to plan for that. He have to provide financial advice and financial informations, clear informations to the organization. And he must review the risk in the particular field. Like that, his work is more important. And he is a person who helps the organization to enjoy the tax benefit. And next, ICWA. Actually, it is a 3 years course. Here also we have three stages: foundation, intermediate, and final exams we have. After completion of your ICWA, your career options are finance director, managing director, accountant, cost controller, chief auditor, cost accountant, chief internal auditor, financial consultant, managing director. So next, we are going to discuss about the job opportunities available for BCom graduates. After completion of UG, some students are in the position to secure a job. Job is more important for them. So they can search a job in these fields: corporate sector, banking, sales tax department, customs department, excise department, import and export companies, Indian civil service, fast moving consumer goods, advertising, journalism, etc. Here, bank offer job opportunities to the BCom graduates. The bank recruit candidates in two levels. Number one is clerical level, and second one is official level. After completion of your BCom degree, you can join as a tax consultant. In early stage, in the beginning, you can join as an assistant in any tax consultancy enterprise. After securing a knowledge and experience, you can start your own enterprise. To become a tax consultant, you need written verbal communication skill, knowledge of tax laws, max proficiency, analytical thinking skill. These are the area, key skills you need for tax consultant. And now we are going to discuss about the competitive exams. After completion of your competitive exams, you can appear for some exams conducted at national level and state level to secure a government job. For that, we have to crack one entrance exam. In entrance exam, same procedure, they used to test your arithmetic accuracy, English language skill, and local logical reasoning and data interpretation. Same pattern is continue here also. First one is the Institute of Banking Personnel Section conducts a national level examination for probationary officer. Here, the probationary officer is a grade A exam. When you clear this exam, it is a national level exam conducted every year by the Institute of Banking Personnel Selection. Okay, when you complete or crack this exam, your position will be best in the banks. You can get a placement in private, public, or foreign banks. And next, RBI also offer job opportunity, that is grade B officer job opportunity to the BCom graduates. For that, you have to attend one entrance exam. Here, you have an entrance exam. After that, personal interview will be conducted. And SBI also introduced and giving opportunity for youngsters for probationary officers. It is also a national level exam. Here also we have three stages, namely preliminary exams. Preliminary exams means entrance exams and main exam. In main exam, they used to ask question related to subject, that is related to banking. And last, personal interview. Sometimes it may be group discussion also. SBI also offer clerical post, that is junior assistant. Here also we have four stages, that is preliminary, main, group discussion, and personal interview. And IBPS clerk exams is conduct across the nation to recruit candidates for clerical post at IBPS. The exam is conducted in two stages, that is preliminary round and main exam. And you can get a job in SBI or similar banks. The Staff Selection Commission conducts exams for the post of inspector, income tax officer, assistant section officer, and assistant enforcement officer. The eligibility criteria for different posts varies. Being BCom graduate, you can apply for the post of an assistant audit officer, statistical investigator, grade 2. Okay. And in Indian Railways also, we have more vacancies. Every year, thousands of employees are retiring from railways. Railways provide opportunities to the youngsters. It conducts an entrance exam and you have to clear that. Okay. And finally, LIC, that is Life Insurance Corporation of India, conduct an exam for recruitment of Assistant Administrative Officer. Assistant Administrative Officer, government posting actually. The minimum eligibility is any UG degree is enough for this. It is an entry-level officer. Here, you can get a job like supervising subordinators, general administration, and working to increase insurance business like that. To conclude and sum up, let me highlight the points which we discussed in this session. First, we have discussed the importance of self-evaluation. Here, I already told you, before selecting your career, you should know about yourself. You should know about your psychological profile, which makes you happy, which is more important for you, which gives enjoyment, in which field you have interest. Like that, you have to decide and find out the career. It's more important, ma, because if you choose a wrong one, it make you in hell for the next 40 to 50 years, friend. Because you and your family members enjoy the fruit of your hard work and you can provide job opportunity for others. And you will surely get a best place in the society. One of my students who started foodie industry, he started supplying breakfast, lunch, and dinner to IT industries. Slowly, he developed herself. And I come across one more girl who has utilized this pandemic situation. She has introduced online tuitions on spoken English courses for kids. Slowly, she developed within this 3 to 4 months. Okay. In our area, four young boys join together and they plan this pandemic situation. They used to deliver vegetables and provisions to the needy people and charge service charges from them. So, to become an entrepreneur, you need a creativity. Just go through the situations and use it for yourself and be your own boss. Okay, next topic is academic courses and exams. After completion of your BCom, you can join MBA, MCom, CA, CS, ICWA. I'll start my lecture with MBA. MBA means Master in Business Administration, and we have many specialization in MBA. MBA specialization offers promotes career development, induce career changes, enhance knowledge, skill, and abilities development, leads to personal development. And these are the area we have specialization in MBA. MBA in finance, marketing, human resources, international business, operation management, rural management, agribusiness management. And many of the engineering colleges and arts and science colleges offer MBA degree. But when you crack MBA degree in famous top universities or top institutes, you will get a best place, because in future we are in need of MBA graduates. When you complete your MBA degree, you can be placed in a multinational company with a good package of salary. Okay, so next we will see the specializations. Before that, to complete your MBA in famous institute like Indian Institute of Management, you have to crack one common exam, that is CAT exam, Common Admission Test. This test is an All India test conducted by Indian Institute of Management. So, to get a chance to study in famous institute, you have to crack this exam, CAT exam. And the bachelor, that is UG, if you have for that, to crack the MBA exams, entrance exam, you must score at least 50% in your bachelor degree, and you will get the, you can search and find out the details in website also. And for CAT exam, actually, it is a 3 hours exam. Here, they used to test your quantitative ability, verbal ability, reading comprehensions, data interpretation, and logical reasoning. In quantitative ability, they used to check your arithmetic accuracy. You have to solve the problem within a minimum period, because you have only 3 hours and you have 34 questions. 34 questions will be given to you. So you need regular practice. Many institute provides training for this CAT exams. Otherwise, you can download the material from the website and practice at home. It will help you. But practice alone help you to score marks. Next, in verbal ability and reading comprehension, they used to check your English knowledge, grammar. These are the famous institute where you can complete or join your MBA. Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, Ahmedabad, Calcutta, Delhi, Madras, Lucknow, Kozhikode. Like this. So you can have a, after cracking your CAT exam, you can join in any one of these institute and get a best placement
in any multinational company. Once again. Next, if you want to select or join MBA in finance, and these are your career opportunities, career options: expert in financial management related areas, banking sectors, insurance industries, mutual funds industries, stock exchange, financial consulting, manager of the highly responsible departments and functions in the organization pertaining, assistant manager, like that. Okay, when you sell, and these are the subjects in MBA in finance: financial management, managerial economics, accounting for managers, like that. These are the subjects. And next, when you select MBA in marketing, we all know, aware of that, marketing is a backbone of an organization. When you select marketing in MBA, your career options will be marketing manager, head of digital marketing, product manager, media planner, sales manager, brand manager, corporate sales manager, market research analyst. When you select MBA in HR as your career options will be team player, team leader, assistant HR manager, regional HR manager, senior HR manager, director HR, chief HR officer. And when you choose MBA in international business, your career options will be international foreign policy advisor, the international trading and customs manager, business development director, multinational manager, financial collector, international marketing director. When you select MBA in operation management, your career options will be, when you choose MBA in Agri Business Management, your career options can be Agri Industries, Food Industries, Farm Engineering, Livestock Industries, like that. And if you are really interested in teaching after completion of your BCom, you can select MCom. After completion of your MCom, you can join PhD part-time or full-time. While doing PhD, you can clear state level and national level eligibility tests conducted in national and state level. Actually, MCom is a 2 years course. And next is, we are going to discuss about company secretaryship. After completion of company secretaryship course, you can be placed in key managerial person in an organization. Key managerial person means he is a top authority of an organization. While doing company secretaryship, you may have a knowledge, you may increase your knowledge, you are trained in particular fields. Example, finance, accounting, legal, administrative, personal areas, etc. Actually, to clear this, we have to complete three steps. First, you have to attend one entrance exam. The entrance is after 2020, they have changed the method of CS exams. First, you have to crack this CSEET test, that is Company Secretaryship Executive Entrance Test. You can or eligible to attend this test after completion of your 12th standard. And second stage is executive exams. And to join the executive exam directly, you have one more option. That is, if you cleared foundation in CS or CA or ICWA, you can directly join in executive exams. And third stage is professional exams. In professional exams, we have three modules and some papers is also discussed. And your career options are secretary in HR, marketing, administration, CEO office, and in finance. Chartered accountant. Chartered accountant is a dream of all the commerce students. When a student select commerce as a subject in 11th standard, they want to join CA course and complete CA course. They want to become a chartered accountant. But you need training, because here also we have three stages. But first one is foundation, second one is intermediate, and third one is final exam. And after completion of your chartered accountant, you can be an auditor of any company. I won't say career opportunities for chartered accountant, because chartered accountant, job of chartered accountant is very different, responsible job. He is a person who is responsible for the financial position of the organization. So here I have listed out the responsibilities of chartered accountant. So he have to manage financial system and budget, and he have to plan for that. He have to provide financial advice and financial informations, clear informations to the organization. And he must review the risk in the particular field. Like that, his work is more important. And he is a person who helps the organization to enjoy the tax benefit. And next, ICWA. Actually, it is a 3 years course. Here also we have three stages: foundation, intermediate, and final exams we have. After completion of your ICWA, your career options are finance director, managing director, accountant, cost controller, chief auditor, cost accountant, chief internal auditor, financial consultant, managing director. So next, we are going to discuss about the job opportunities available for BCom graduates. After completion of UG, some students are in the position to secure a job. Job is more important for them. So they can search a job in these fields: corporate sector, banking, sales tax department, customs department, excise department, import and export companies, Indian civil service, fast moving consumer goods, advertising, journalism, etc. Here, bank offer job opportunities to the BCom graduates. The bank recruit candidates in two levels. Number one is clerical level, and second one is official level. After completion of your BCom degree, you can join as a tax consultant. In early stage, in the beginning, you can join as an assistant in any tax consultancy enterprise. After securing a knowledge and experience, you can start your own enterprise. To become a tax consultant, you need written verbal communication skill, knowledge of tax laws, max proficiency, analytical thinking skill. These are the area, key skills you need for tax consultant. And now we are going to discuss about the competitive exams. After completion of your competitive exams, you can appear for some exams conducted at national level and state level to secure a government job. For that, we have to crack one entrance exam. In entrance exam, same procedure, ma. They used to test your arithmetic accuracy, English language skill, and local logical reasoning and data interpretation. Same pattern is continue here also. First one is the Institute of Banking Personnel Section conducts a national level examination for probationary officer. Here, the probationary officer is a grade A exam. When you clear this exam, it is a national level exam conducted every year by the Institute of Banking Personnel Selection. Okay, when you complete or crack this exam, your position will be best in the banks. You can get a placement in private, public, or foreign banks. And next, RBI also offer job opportunity, that is grade B officer job opportunity, to the BCom graduates. For that, you have to attend one entrance exam. Here, you have an entrance exam. After that, personal interview will be conducted. And SBI also introduced and giving opportunity for youngsters for probationary officers. It is also a national level exam. Here also we have three stages, namely preliminary exams. Preliminary exams means entrance exams and main exam. In main exam, they used to ask question related to subject, that is related to banking. And last, personal interview. Sometimes it may be group discussion also. SBI also offer clerical post, that is junior assistant. Here also we have four stages, that is preliminary, main, group discussion, and personal interview. And IBPS clerk exams is conduct across the nation to recruit candidates for clerical post at IBPS. The exam is conducted in two stages, that is preliminary round and main exam. And you can get a job in SBI or similar banks. The Staff Selection Commission conducts exams for the post of inspector, income tax officer, assistant section officer, and assistant enforcement officer. The eligibility criteria for different posts varies. Being BCom graduate, you can apply for the post of an assistant audit officer, statistical investigator, grade 2. Okay. And in Indian Railways also, we have more vacancies. Every year, thousands of employees are retiring from railways. Railways provide opportunities to the youngsters. It conducts entrance exam and you have to clear that. Okay. And finally, LIC, that is Life Insurance Corporation of India, conduct an exam for recruitment of Assistant Administrative Officer. Assistant Administrative Officer, government posting actually. The minimum eligibility is any UG degree is enough for this. It is an entry-level officer. Here you can get a job like supervising subordinators, general administration, and working to increase insurance business like that. To conclude and sum up, let me highlight the points which we discussed in this session. First, we have discussed the importance of self-evaluation. Here I already told you, before selecting your career, you should know about yourself. You should know about your psychological profile, which makes you happy, which is more important for you, which gives enjoyment, in which field you have interest. Like that, you have to decide. and find out the career. It's more important, ma, because if you choose a wrong one, it make you in hell for the next 40 to 50 years, because the career continues for 40 to 50 years. When you select the right one, it gives enjoyment. You feel more happy. Okay. And next, in next session, next point, we have discussed the importance of English language. I already told you, English is more important for our communication. At regular practice, you can improve your English language. Read every day, read loudly for 30 minutes. That practice will improve your English language. And we had a discussion about entrepreneurship. Who is an entrepreneur? And I have given many examples of entrepreneur. And what are the characteristics of entrepreneur? And we had a discussion in academic courses, that is from MBA to ICWA. We have discussed many courses. And what are all the job opportunities available for the BCom students? And what are all the competitive exams for you, that is for BCom graduates? Anyhow, I wish all the best for all the students. And thank you once again. I thank the management and the organizers and teaching faculties. Thank you very much, ma'am.